after we went to my car, when I streamed, we went to another spot downtown, right? We went downtown. We went downtown, and then this one spot made us have fucking masks. So we're like, fuck that shit. Fuck that shit. We ain't get no fucking masks for this stupid ass shit. But guess what? Okay, watch this. So the first spot we went to with a mask, bullshit. Didn't go. The next spot, we're walking down. We're walking downtown. We're just walking down everywhere, all different spots and shit. So the next spot we go to, I give him. I gotta go to the bathroom, which I do. I gotta go to the fucking bathroom. I give homeboy the ID. He's like, "Oh, you gotta be 21, boss." And I'm like, "Check again." y'all don't know how that felt to me in that moment, bro. I was already drinking a little bit. You know what I'm saying? That, bro, that felt so player and just so smooth to say in that moment. Like, "You gotta be 21, boss." I'm like, "Oh, you gotta be 21." I'm like, "Check again, homie. It's my lucky day. Check again." He said, "Damn, bro, shit, you 21? You look, you know what I'm saying? Hey, happy birthday, bro. You know, you can get some free, you can get some drinks. You know, you can go, there was the upstairs where they got a little balcony. You know what I'm saying? Downstairs, boom, boom, right?" Nigga, what the fuck you talking about? Nigga, 21. All right, anyway, boom. And now that was bullshit. So we left. We just kind of messing with some honeys over there. Just like talking to them and shit. Nothing crazy. And y'all, why does so many chicks want to do a fucking dick doc with me Saturday night? Why? Do I look like a dick doc ass nigga to y'all? Hello? Like, be honest. Do I look like a dick doc ass nigga to y'all? Y'all are not funny. So picture this is a Corona bottle, right? Chick had a Corona bottle, right? Post it up like that. Okay? Post it up like them. And then she put her phone on that bitch. And she's like, "Oh, shit, you're cute. Come in and do it, bro. Come in." And she's like, "You don't want to be in it? Okay." So she played a song. She just go away. It's like second nature to her. Like, what the fuck you got going, chick? And she just. Looking like body bagging this motherfucker. Like. And Sean and I looking like after she do all that shit, we go in the camera and we look like this. The fuck is And she posted. The bitch posted it. Y'all, she posted that motherfucker. She posted that bitch. After she doing all this monkey ass shit. Shit. We do this. Get in a little bit. She posted. I'm like, "Oh, hell no. I don't know you from a can of paint. What the fuck? What's good with you, Cookie? What's happening with you, Mom? What's good, girl? What's good?" So, boom. Anyway, that was kind of cool, right? And then, he said, Cloud Chaser. And then we go to another spot. And this spot right here, jumping. And I mean jumping. Stamped up. You know what I'm saying? We walking that motherfucker, right? People just talking, like, we don't have, like, Sean and I, well, I, first, we're just the type of people that people just automatically just, like, gravitate towards, because most people, especially if they're going, like, in a going out scene and, like, in a club scene, people are putting up a facade, a front. They're not this on Tuesday. They're not this on Wednesday. They're only this when it comes Friday, Saturday, and when they hung over on Sunday. They're not like this shit. So people just talk to, "Oh, you want to get a drink? Free drink? I'll buy you some drinks." And Sean, the whole night, Sean was telling people, "Yo, look, it's my brother's birthday. It's my brother's birthday. Yada, yada, yada." Mind you, let me tell you this. We meet a white dude. He's like 5'10", right? White dude, crazy, like reddish, what's that, ginger beard? Kind of, sort of, right? Long, like right here. His birthday is January 23rd, too. And we, bro, after the club that needed us to wear a mask to get in, we saw him bar hop each and every club that we was going to, right? So we go to this spot, we meet him, bro. "Oh, it's your birthday for real?" He's like, "Let me see some ID. Let's exchange some IDs." He gives me his ID. I give him mine. And we're just talking, bro. He's like, man, but you're 21. Like, man, you're such an old soul. And we just talking. He's like, bro, I could just feel your energy a mile away, man. Like, blessings to you. Keep calling me King. He like, blessings to you, King, man. Just positivity. Stay upbeat. Keep your head on straight. You know what I'm saying? Whatever you want to manifest. White dude. White dude. And we just having a great build. We just having a great conversation in the middle of the fucking street. And then we go to the next club. We dance. We chilling, right? He got a son. He got like a 7-year-old son. He telling me about his life and shit carrying on. And yeah, boom, right? So now, let me tell y'all this. Y'all listen to this. Y'all about to laugh. Listen to this shit. So boom, we go to, we go back to the spot that needs us to have a mass, right? And this at this time, it's like 2:30 maybe. 2:30 a.m., right? It's 2:30 or some shit. We go back to the spot, they're closed, or they're closing down. Like, people are coming out the club, motherfuckers sweeping and mopping and shit. They're closing down. So we go around the back way where they got like a back low entrance and exit. Motherfuckers running out, and not running, but they walking out the club. A fight about to break out. Number of white people, drunk, loud, right? While I'm talking to the Aquarius dude, who's his birthday, you know, whatever. These motherfuckers come out the club. It was two dudes, okay? So hear me out. So it was two dudes. It was one, the dude was 53. He was a GQ looking motherfucker. Y'all know how Arnold Schwarzenegger looked like? Give me a one if y'all know who Arnold Schwarzenegger is. Arnold Schwarzenegger, the motherfucking bodybuilder looking motherfucker. Let me get y'all a picture. For those of y'all who don't know. Arnold Schwartz. This stocky motherfucker. This dude. Okay? He looked pretty much like him. His beard was like shorter, right? He was clean cut, clean shave and all that shit around the face. Hair same way. Hair was the same fucking way, okay? So now y'all got a good picture. He the governor of Cali? Oh, hell no. Nah. This matrix is fucked up. Anyway, so boom. He's 53. He's like 5'9", 5'10". And his homeboy, he got a beer belly, you know, he got a fucking, you know what I'm saying? He got the fucking Arnold Schwarzenegger type hair, fucked up hairline. His teeth is kind of yellow. You know, I'm just peeping out their motherfucking MO. You know, I'm just peeping out their motherfucking forte. That's all I'm doing. And he's a surgeon. He's like a very famous and popular surgeon. Now, those two dudes and this one dude, bro, mind you, it's cold as shit. And in Louisiana, 45, 50 is cold. So, and we're in the city. So this white dude, the other white dude, he comes out the club with a black tank top on, some black jeans, and some like runner shoes. Some like Nike runner shoes. And he's like, he screams, man, I'm gonna fuck these racists up. I'm gonna fuck them up. With his tank top on. I'm gonna fuck them up, man. Fuck that. I'm gonna fuck them up. That's some bullshit. Right? And so, I'm peeping. Sean and I, we peeping. What's going on? You know what I'm saying? And a chick is holding the tank top dude back. So we gonna call Arnold and Surgeon. So Arnold and Surgeon are over here. We're gonna call Tank and his chick over here, right? So his chick, what the fuck she gonna do? She ain't holding back a fucking dog, let alone this motherfucker on road rage, right? So Tank and chick over here, Arnold and Surgeon over here. Motherfucker come out the club, man, I'm gonna fuck you up, Tank. I'm gonna fuck you, man, I'm gonna fuck you up, man, you racist motherfuckers, you piece of shit, yada, yada. Arnold and Surgeon are just screaming at this man. Man, you ain't gonna do nothing. Shut the fuck up. Shut the fuck up. So they just going back and forth. The chick walk him down to the end of the street, go back to the car. They all drunk, out they mind, drunk, and all some other shit. But we're going to get into that. They all going crazy, right? And we kind of go towards, like, the street. And Sean and I break it up. Like, yo, go about your business. Do what you got to do. Do your thing. It ain't even nothing to really be stunned about. Come on now. Like, you know what I'm saying? And he's like, oh, you're with these? Tank. He's like, oh, you're with these racists? You with these? I'm like, I don't know these motherfuckers. I don't know them. Shit, I want to chill out. Hey, I don't even know them. He's like, oh, okay. All right, well, fuck y'all then. Fuck y'all. And Arnold then, fuck you too then, you racist. You cracker. You lugger. And they white too. So I'm laughing. Sean and I just laughing. And we walk them down. They go about their way. And Sean and I end up with Arnold and Surgeon. Here's where it gets interesting. We're on a corner. Downtown New Orleans. We're on a corner, right? We're just talking. This mother... Okay, hold on. I gotta give y'all like a visual, like to hear. So y'all know those like hold on, how can I put this? Y'all know those announcers, like those boxing announcers? Like, okay. Michael Buffer.
For the thousands in attendance.
Yep.
And the millions watching around the world on HBO pay-per-view. Ladies and gentlemen, from Mandalay Bay, Las Vegas, let's get ready to rumble!
Okay, cool. Y'all hear that? Great. Perfect. Fine. So now, Surgeon, his beard belly looking ass boy, he got a motherfucking dog sitting up in his motherfucking chest. His voice was like that. He's so drunk. He hanging on to Sean, hanging on to me. You know what I'm saying? Doing shit like that. But he's singing songs. Y'all know Frank Sinatra? He's singing, Fly me to the moon. And Sean and I just laughing hysterically. We just laughing at these niggas. Surgeon just wants to show somebody he got some skill with his motherfucking, you know, with his vocal cords, I guess. It's kind of weird to some dudes, right? But he just going to town. Fly me to the moon. The moon. We sitting there like, bro. And look, it gets y'all. Listen, please follow me with this story. It's crazy, right? So Surgeon is loud. He's like, shut the fuck up to Arnold. Shut the fuck up. You don't know what the fuck you're talking about. Shut the fuck up. You're just too sexy. You don't know what the fuck you're saying. So then they get in an argument. And y'all, Arnold is cool. Like, Arnold is real smooth. Like, he's a smooth... Bro, oh my God. And this is what I said in a moment. Look. Give me a one if y'all seen Wolf of Wall Street. The movie. Wolf of Wall Street. Who seen it? Oh, what's it? Okay. Look. Yep. Got him. Yep. Leonardo DiCaprio. Look. This is exactly how he was, but with gray, like gray beard and the same hair, right? Same hair, fucked up hairline, and gray beard. Okay, but it was like trimmed up a little bit, right? It's kind of just like his beard right here. Okay, now y'all got a visual. So now y'all know what I'm saying. Now, homie, Surgeon, yeah, that was a hell of a movie. Loved it. Top five movies for me. Surgeon kept screaming and saying, oh, shut the fuck up. You fucking GQ looking. Ah, shut up, you sexy. You're just too sexy. Oh, that's why you fucked my wife. But you don't want to tell me you fucked my wife. Fly me to the moon. Ah, shut the fuck up. Huh? So look, Arnold gravitates more towards me. So he's talking to me more. And he like pulled me to the side. Bro, this motherfucker is just going in the middle of the street. Cars flying by. Sean got to pull him back. You know, whatever. So then an argument began with them. Arnold fucked his wife. The wife hasn't told Surgeon And Arnold hasn't told Surgeon either. So he is just kind of being like intuitive over the years. But bro, listen, if y'all have seen Wolf of Wall Street and y'all know Leonardo DiCaprio, then y'all know that these motherfuckers were on that booger sugar, on that hi, on that motherfucking yeah, on that real yeah shit, okay? So they offered me some of that Snow White, some of that Kool-Aid mix. You know what I'm saying? They offered me some of that shit. And I'm like, I don't even smoke, bro. I don't even do none of that shit, man. He's like, well, what about Percocets? What about Molly? And meanwhile, homie, look, Arnold got me on the side, and he's actually trying to, you know, talk to me and shit. Meanwhile, both of them are famous. GQ Arnold is telling me, yo, you know, like, I'm actually pretty famous, and he's trying to talk my head off, but I'm too hip to that shit. Whether I'm drinking or not, I'm too hip to that. So Arnold is talking to me, and he's like, yeah, you know, I was actually on a cover when I was in my mid-20s. He's 53, like I said. Arnold is 53. When I was in my mid-20s, I was on the cover of GQ magazine, you know. I worked at a gay strip club for 15 years and just made money, like, on the side. While, bro, Arnold works, or he said worked. He said Arnold worked for the Surgeon, like, being a helper. And Arnold told me that Surgeon has saved two of his boys' lives. One of them got shot, and he saved his life, like, right at his crib. You know, he's just that good and witty with the shit Surgeon we talking about. And then another one of his boys, I think, just got rushed to the hospital, and he saved two people's lives in, like, I don't know, like, 5 years or something, right? And Surgeon, meanwhile, like, he's just flying me. Let's get right Just me. Arnold's talking. Like, bro, why don't you, like, pay attention to this? Like, why don't you know what I'm saying? Like, he's like, nobody cares. He's drunk as hell. Nobody cares. Nobody cares. I say they're like, nobody cares. I just did it because nobody cares. Like, who fucking cares? And I'm like, bro, we do. Like, you're on the inside looking, but on outsiders looking in, bro, that's an amazing accomplishment. That's an amazing deed to do to somebody. Save their lives. When you don't, number one, you didn't have to. They were already dying. Cause that's what he told me. One of the homeboys got shot. The homeboy who got shot, he was already pronounced dead. But he said, fuck that, I'm saving his life. And he did it. And he's like, nobody cares. Just nobody cares, man. Fly, dude. I'm like, yo, stop. He's saying, like, so Arnold was kind of giving him his flowers right then and there. You know, I kind of felt Arnold's heart. You know, he's kind of exerting some type of love for his homeboy. I could tell that they don't do that, you know, because they're men and macho and shit like that. So they don't really let their friends know, you know, how they really feel and shit. But anyway, back to the fight about fucking his wife. Surgeon says to me, he says, nobody want to tell me. Just nobody want to, and that's how he speaks. Nobody want to tell me. Just nobody want to tell me. He just fucked my wife. And meanwhile, GQ Arnold is sitting back laughing like, he's like, nobody want to tell me. Nobody want to fucking tell me. That's okay. I mean, he just fucked my wife. He just fucked my wife, bro. He just fucked my wife. So meanwhile, Sean is sitting up there laughing, and then he kind of quiets down and he starts talking to Sean, and Surgeon then starts talking. And me and GQ, we kind of go some steps ahead and we start talking, and he's like, and I'm like, did you? Like, you know, keep it 100, you know, we're right here with it. He's like, you know, how about it? You know, it's, yeah, I did. Manipulating ass nigga. Come on, bro. Manipulating ass nigga. He looked at me and said, you know what I mean? Yeah, I did. I did. Right? So we sitting there. I'm sitting there. I'm like, damn, bro. Like, you know, what was, like, the time frame? He's like, I mean, I don't know. I mean, his wife's a fucking slut. I mean, you know, I mean, I told you, I worked in strip clubs. You know, I've seen this, I've seen that. You know, when I was younger, I didn't really give a fuck. I'm just fucking, just to fuck, and you know, right? And he's like, yeah, you know, probably like a couple years ago, you know, I fucked her and, you know, I had sex with her and, you know, all this different type of shit, right? And then Surgeon and Sean kind of creep up again, and meanwhile, this nigga keeps saying, oh, what the fuck you saying over here, man? The hell are you saying? The hell are you saying? And of course, GQ doesn't want to say that, you know, he fucked his wife while he's drunk, you know? They're both drunk, but at least Arnold was more chill with this shit, you know what I'm saying? So anyway, fast forward, that conversation gets died down, and my car is on this block. They don't know which one is my car, right? I don't let them know that shit. Gotta think ahead of these motherfuckers. So, we're kind of walking straight a little bit. And before we get to my car, they asked me. Well, GQ, really. He's like, yeah, you know, we're famous. You know, we have a lot of credentials, man. You know, we're famous, you know, yada, yada, yada. But we're drunk as fuck, man. But, hey, you know what? I think Sean does. I don't know if Sean told him that it was my birthday. But for the story's sake, let's just say that he did. So, he's like, oh, it's your birthday? Oh, shit, you 21? God damn, 21, blah, blah, blah. Let's just say, right? Fast forward, GQ Arnold, he's like, shit, oh, well, there's this place called, I forgot the place, I'm being honest, but let's just say it's a strip club. Well, shit, they got a strip club downtown, not too far from here, shit, well, shit, how about y'all give us a ride? You go to the strip club. We go to the top floor. We go to the penthouse. I'll pay for all y'all's nights. I'll pay for the whole thing. If you want a happy ending, if you want a this, if you want a that, I'll pay for it. But we go to the top floor. But if we go to the top floor, you have to make sure that you take cocaine, sniff it off their ass, and ask them for a gold bar and to shove it up their ass. I cannot make this up. I literally can't make this up if I wanted to. He says to me, Arnold, he said, if we're going to the strip club, we're going to the top floor, and you have to ask the strippers to put a gold bar and stuff it up their ass. He's like, you know how chicks will do fucking, you know, cucumbers or bananas up there, you know, a gold bar. What? I'm like, bro, I don't even like indulge, like, I don't even, you know what I'm saying? I don't even do drugs, I don't even do none of that shit, bro. He's like, oh, come on, man. Come on, man. Fly to the moon. I'm like, bro, I don't even do that shit. Like, I'm not even about to, whatever, right? I'm not about to do that dumbass shit. And they're mainly Arnold is trying to entice me to go to the strip club and give him a ride. So we get to my car. They find out what car. Sean gets on the other side, and he gets in the car, and bro, I'm so swift. That's why y'all gotta be so aware, bro. Y'all gotta be aware. Don't be scared. Don't be afraid. But just gotta be aware. So this is what I do. I get to my car. I unlock my car. Sean gets in. And then I don't open my door yet. Because they're like a couple steps back. Oh, I missed the part. My bad. I missed the part. So in between this motherfucker singing, fly me, hanging on to us. Fly me to the moon. Meanwhile, he's doing all this nut ass shit, right? Bro, he's like grabbing Sean's chest and like coming real close to his ear. You know what I'm saying? Like coming real close to his fucking ear and kind of like trying to put his tongue, you know what I'm saying? Trying to put his tongue by his ear and like on his neck and shit. And Sean's like, whoa, the fuck? And I kind of peep it because me and GQ, he's trying to like get my attention to go which way. And I'm like, nah, I'm focused, big dog. Like, you know what I'm saying? Surgeon is doing this, not GQ. Surgeon is exploiting this shit. I'm like, what the fuck? And Sean, you know, Sean's being nice. Sean's a little turned too, but he's still aware. Like, what the fuck? Oh. And he and Surgeon just keeps getting closer and closer and closer. So we get to my car, right? I'm talking to him a little bit, and we're not going to the strip club. We don't want to go to the penthouse. Or maybe I think we say, like, something along the lines of, Oh shit, we gonna see. Nah, baby, we'll do. We gonna see. We gonna see. We gonna do the strip. We gonna see. We gonna see me. The night's still young, right? So I hurry up, get in my car, turn my engine on, turn my car on, and I put my window down, right? And it's surging right here. So my car, it's surging on my fucking window, right by my goddamn door, and Arnold GQ is behind him, right? So we're sitting there, and Sean is like, shit, we need to pull off, bro. We need to pull the fuck off. These motherfuckers are going crazy. We need to pull off. And I'm like, all right, you know, keep it on, you know, simple. So I, right when I get in my car, I lock that bitch. Guess what Arnold do? Arnold yanks on my back door, on my passenger side door. He yanks on that bitch. Yo, bro, let's just go to the strip club, bro. Give us a ride, man. Help out the poor. That's what he say. He say, help out the poor, man. Come on. All these, bro, all these mental, psychological tactics, bro, you got the right one, Arnold. You got the right one, Wolf of Wall Street, nigga. I ain't going with that shit. So, boom, he's yanking on my goddamn back passenger door. He's yanking on that bitch. Like, bro, give us a ride, man. And meanwhile, I'm like, nah, we ain't going. Get off my door, bro. We ain't doing that shit. He gets off my door a little bit, and I roll up my window. I'm like, nah, yeah, we going, bro. We going to the next spot. I can get y'all a ride. We going. I roll up my window, and guess what fucking surgeon does? This motherfucking surgeon is looking at me through my goddamn window like this. Fly me to the moon. His eyes is going one in, one out. Look like this. On my fucking hand. His hand is on top of my goddamn Jeeper beeper. Looking like this. Fly me to the moon. Right? Eyes going in and out, looking like Fetty Wap. Bro, before I'm about to pull off, because I think I put my car in reverse a little bit. To not hit the car in front of me. Bro, he puts his hand on the top of my fucking car. He puts his mouth and his lips on my motherfucking window. And he does this. I ain't go, that's kind of weird. Ugh, it's weird. Fucking weird. Fuck off my shit, boy. Weird as fuck. But he does that shit up and down over my fucking window. What the fuck y'all got? What the fuck you got going? Meanwhile, they're fruity. You know you liked it, perp nerd. That's not funny. That's something you don't joke about. That's not funny at all. But anyway, he's doing that shit on my window. And I'm like, hey, the fuck off my window, bro. The fuck? And he's still... So, reverse, put in drive, zoom. And I kind of roll my window down. I knew they about to say something. I roll my window down a little bit. And he says, oh, shut the hell up, you fucking... F word. He goes, fuck you fucking F words. You fucking. I'm like, yeah. So Sean and I, we go to the next spot, park our car around the corner, and then we have a phenomenal fucking time at the next spot. So that was pretty fucking crazy. That was pretty crazy, y'all. And that right there is what happened. Excluding, you know, the dances, the fun shit, you know, excluding all of that, that is just a little bit of, a little bit of Saturday night. One thing I heard, hey, was that a W story time or what? Because that was real. That was all real. Y'all know I don't lie, nothing. W story time or what? Hey, yeah, that shit was crazy, bro. Asked me to do cocaine. Bro, and y'all know how many times I got offered to do cocaine and take some pills and shrooms, and I'm already high already. The fuck I need this shit for? Fly me to the moon. Hey, Kadim, this will be on a plug channel too, but we're going to have to edit this out.
Fly me to the moon, let me play
see what spring is like on a Jupiter Mars. In other words, hold my hand. Bro, this dude's voice was just going nuts all night with just songs. Baby, kiss me. Fill my heart with song. Like, what? What the hell is wrong with these niggas, man? So I'm like, God damn. Oh! Oh, Slips. Whoa, Slippertons. Slipperton has now stepped in the billions. Happy late glow day. Happy late glow day, bro. Hey, wait, I'm about to replay that, Slips. Hold on, let me put this motherfucker up in this bitch. Slips, 510 titty bitties, man. Thank you, bro. Hold on, let me do this motherfucking shit real quick. But y'all, that was a crazy, bro. Cause guess what? That little second of me not moving, bro. Guess what? He could have been in my motherfucking car. He could have been in my motherfucking whip. Took, bro. I had some shit in my back seat. I had some money back there. I had all type of shit back there. You know what I'm saying? He could have. You know? Oh my God, the alert, hold on. Oh, there you go. Fly me to you. It is my. All right, hold on. Let's run that shit back. Let's run that shit the fuck back. Gotta get that motherfucker some justice, ain't it?
Happy late glow day.
Happy you day, bro. Happy you day, man. Jesus. Thank you, Slips. Yeah, and shout out to everybody who got gifted from Zeno. Shit.
Fly me to the moon.
Yeah, Zeno went crazy. Yeah, Zeno went crazy one time for the one time, man. So. Yeah, that was, yeah. I couldn't make that up if I wanted to, bro. You know? The women were, you know, they were all right. You know, I didn't really. It wasn't, bro. Sean and I just had a great time. Sean and I had just a fucking phenomenal time. But bro, so many motherfuckers. Why did motherfuckers offer me all that shit? Like weed. Like all them, like, hard-ass drugs and shit. I don't. Like, I'm sorry. Fly me to the moon. Is it because you black? Wow, really? That's it right there? Because I'm black. That's kind of interesting because I don't think, besides weed, I don't think, yeah, black people have never offered me cocaine, Molly, Percocets, Nathan. Not a fucking thing. Damn, Deshaun, you up to something, boy. Shit, that's a true statement right there. Well, right now, shit, I know motherfuckers who do that boogie sugar shit, you know what I'm saying? But, hey, it's all good in the hood. Yo, Bezo, what's happening with it, big dog? First time chat view, what's happening? Because JB, you vibe with everyone. Weed smokers, coke sniffers.